Hello and welcome in this video of money and credit. In this video we are going to understand about the meaning of money and the credit system. We will also have a introduction about the banking system and the credit system in the banks. So if you can remember our last chapter, in our last chapter we studied about economic activity, in which we studied that any kind of activity with the objective to earn money is called an economic activity. We also studied about the three sectors of Indian economy, that is the primary, secondary and the tertiary sector. In this video we are going to understand about the meaning of the money and the credit system and the self-help groups. So let's begin our chapter. So these are the main topics which are included in the chapter of the money and credit: the modern form of money, the loan activities of the bank, the different credit situation, terms of credit and the self-help groups. So let's start our chapter. So if we try to understand the meaning of the money, we can say that the money is a medium of exchange which is required in our day-to-day transaction. So any goods or services can be purchased with the help of the money. Money is acceptable to every people in the different countries. So money is a thing which anybody will accept, and in exchange of the money he can purchase any kind of goods and service. So it is the definition of the money. Money is a term which is used as a medium of exchange. In the modern economy, money is marked as an intermediary. It is a medium of exchange for goods and services, also used for the payment of debts. So this is the main definition of the money. So let's understand about the concept of the money. Let's make our understanding clear. So this is the coins which is used in the ancient India. Money is not new in our country. Even during the time of Indus Valley civilization, we have observed some kind of seals that was practiced for trade in the Indus Valley civilization period. So it is a gold coin which was practiced during the time of Akbar, and it is a paper currency. It is a modern type of money. So what kind of differences do you get between these two? It is, if we talk about this gold coin, it is called the gold mohar. It is used of the gold. Now the internal value of the coin and the external value, that means the value written on the gold coin, is the same. But if we talk about the modern money, it is a paper money. The value of the money is 2000, but it is a paper money on which the government has promised to pay this amount to anybody who bears it, anybody who has it. So it is a promissory note. It don't have value. It don't have its intrinsic value. Its internal value is zero. If we can divide this paper money into two parts, it will lose its value. But if I divide this gold coin, it will not lose its value. The value of the gold will be there. So what I mean to say is that it is a metallic money and it is a paper money, but it has its value. The paper money has its value because it has got the recognition from the government of India itself. I hope that this is clear for everyone, the difference between two. So it is called the two types of money we have studied. One is called the metallic money and another one is called the paper money, or paper money is also called the fiat money. Paper money, another name of the paper money is called the fiat money. So the introduction of the money replaced the barter system. Before the introduction of the money, the exchange of goods and services were happening with the commodity itself. That system was called the barter system. Its name is barter, B-A-R-T-E-R, the barter system. So if we talk about the barter system, it was a kind of exchange service which was used before the introduction of the money. So the barter system is a kind of exchange system. In this, the goods were the goods and services were exchanged to complete the mutual needs. Now, one of the limitation of the barter system was the double coincidence of wants. In this system, both the parties should be agreed to sell and purchase each other commodity. Suppose I have rice and I want to purchase ice cream. I have rice and I want to purchase ice cream. Now, the ice cream want cloths, which I don't have. So it in this case, the exchange of the commodities would not be possible. So it is a drawback. It is a weakness of the barter system. So it is called the double coincidence of want. The double coincidence of want tells that if I want to sell my commodity, the another party should also agree to buy my commodity. So it is called the double coincidence of wants. So I hope that it is clear for everyone. So in the double coincidence of wants, both the parties, the seller and the buyer, have to agree to sell and buy each other commodity. For example, I have just explained that suppose I have rice and I want ice cream. Now the person who is selling the ice cream, he wants cloths. Now I don't have the cloth. So in this case, the barter system would not be successful. So to make the barter system successful, both the parties, the seller and the buyer, should be agree to purchase and sell each other commodity. So I hope that the double coincidence of want is clear for everyone. So many times it has appeared in the board exam. What is the meaning of the double coincidence of wants? I hope that you have understood the meaning of it. Let's move. The modern form of money. If we talk about the modern form of money, there are three forms. One is called the currency or the bank notes. Another one is the deposit in the bank. And third one is the check. So the currency, just now we have explained, just now we have discussed that the currency is the bank note. It can be coin or it can be the paper currency. So if we talk about the currency, the Reserve Bank of India issues the currency on behalf of the central government of India. The Reserve Bank of India is the only governmental organization which is responsible for issuing of the currency notes, and it will have the recognition of the government of India. On behalf of the government of India, Reserve Bank of India issues the Indian currency. The deposit in the bank, it means whatever the money is deposited in the bank will also be treated as a currency. It means that whatever the money is deposited in your account, of the bank account, it will also be treated as a money. It can also be used as a money. It can also be, you can also purchase any commodity with the help of your bank deposits. In the form of the check, you can use the bank deposits and purchase any commodity with the online transaction or with the help of the check. Now, what is the meaning of the check? The check means a paper which is instructing the bank to give the amount to any person who is authorized by you. If anybody's name is written in the check issued by you, he will be entitled to get the money from the bank. So check is a kind of paper instructing the bank to give the money to the person whose name is written over there, over the check. So it is a kind of a currency, because it can be used, the check can also be used to buy any commodity or to buy any kind of service. So these are the three main type of currencies which is treated as a modern form of medium of exchange to purchase any commodity. I hope that the bank deposit, the currency and the check is clear for everyone. So the check is a kind of instruction which is given by the account holder to the bank to give this account to another person whose name is written in the check. So currency means the banknote, and the deposit in the bank means whatever the money is deposited in your bank account. So I hope that these three is clear for everyone. Now it is a check. It is a small picture of the check. The name of the payee is written over here. It is account pay. That means the money, 57,000 money, it is the amount written over here. Account pay, it means the money will go to the account only. If you don't have the account, if the bearer don't have the account, it is a bearer. The Prem Kumar would be treated as a bearer. If the bearer don't have the bank account, he has to open the bank account. Otherwise, this check will not be payable. Now, here it will be, if the bearer is written over the check, that means it can be encashed by the bank. But this check cannot be encashed in the bank. The amount will go to the account of this person, Prem Kumar. This is the account number, and this is at the bottom, it is a check number, and it is the coding used by bank to identify the checks, and here the name of the bank is written. So I hope that the check is clear for everyone. The structure of the check, we have recently discussed the structure of the check. The every check is valid for 3 months only. After the 3 months, it will be invalid. So that you must understand. Now, the meaning of the currency. Now, let's discuss about the currency. The modern currency is made of the paper, and the real value of the currency is less than the value written over there. The face value means the value written over the banknote, and the currency note is the modern form of the notes. So, the modern currency is made of the paper. So it don't have its own value, but because the same paper has got the authority of the government of India, so it is also called as a promissory note, and its value increases. Suppose, for example, I explained the differences between the modern currency and the earlier currency, the currency of the Mughal Empire. It is made of the gold and it has its internal value. But here it is made of the modern currency is made of the paper currency, and the paper don't have its own value. But because this paper has got the recognition of the government of India, it has its own value. But if it is teared, if it is torn, or if anything is omitted after 6 years, 7 years, or 10 years, if it is omitted, the picture is omitted, then it will lose its value. So the same thing I want to explain, that the face value is more than the internal value of the paper. The paper don't have its own value. So the currency is authorized by the government of the country, so it is used as a medium of exchange and acceptable by the others. Everybody can accept this because it is issued on behalf of the government of India. So it has its own value. So I hope that the differences between the earlier golden money, the golden metallic currency, and the modern form of money is clear for everyone. This modern money is also called the fiat money, which we have explained just now, and it is called the metallic coins. So I hope that the differences are clear. Now, who issues the currency in India? In India, the currency is issued by the Reserve Bank of India. This is the governmental body which is responsible for issuing of Indian currency or Indian notes on behalf of the central government. The whole Reserve Bank of India is monitored by its governor, the governor of the RBI. So it is a picture of the RBI. The headquarter of the RBI is located in New Delhi. And the governor of the RBI is responsible for managing and monitoring all the activities of the Reserve Bank of India. So the Reserve Bank of India is the chief body, is the sole body and only body responsible for issuing the bank currency in India. It is also called the central bank because it is a bank of the central government of India. All the banks, it may be Axis Bank, it may be State Bank of India or Punjab National Bank or Yes Bank, all the banks inside Indian territory are controlled and supervised by the Reserve Bank of India. So it is called the central bank. So central bank means the bank of the central government of India. Every person has their account in any bank. It may be Axis Bank or the ICICI Bank or the State Bank of India. As every individual, every person have their account in the bank. So every bank have their account in the RBI. So that is why it is called Bank's Bank. It is called the Bank's Bank. It means the bank of the banker. It means the bank of different banks. So RBI is in charge of issuing and exchanging the currency and the coins. I hope that this concept is clear for everyone. So RBI is called the Banker's Bank. It is the bank of the central government of India, and all the banks are supervised by the Reserve Bank of India. So it is a picture of the Reserve Bank of India, whose headquarters is in Mumbai, and it is supervised by the governor of RBI. Shaktikant Das is the present governor of RBI, Reserve Bank of India. So if we try to understand the functions of the RBI, I have recently said that the chief function of the RBI is to issue notes, is to issue the currency notes on behalf of the central government of India. But apart from this, there are some other functions of the RBI, which are, as the first function, issue currency on behalf of the central government. Another one, regulation of the money and credit. How much money should be issued by the RBI? The RBI will decide himself how much money I will issue. If the RBI issues the extra money, it will also be improper. If it issues the less money, it will also create another problem of the lack of currency. Another one, the credit. What will be the interest of the bank to give the loan? If somebody has deposited the money in the bank, what will be the interest? All these are supervised and issued by the RBI itself. All these are the credit system decided by the RBI himself. Now another one, the keep track on the working of another commercial banks. Any commercial bank, whether it can be a government bank or a private bank, whether it is following the rules and regulations or not, because the people deposit their money in the commercial banks. So it is the responsibility of the RBI himself to check whether the bank is following the rules and regulations, or the people's money is safe in the bank or not. So all these things has to be ensured by the Reserve Bank of India. It is the Reserve Bank of India which supervises every bank, that whether the bank is following the rules and regulations or not. It is giving the loans according to the interest decided by the RBI or not. What is the meaning of the commercial bank? So the commercial bank means the Axis Bank, the State Bank of India, the commercial bank means those banks which is concerned with giving the loan to the common people or where the people can deposit their money is called the commercial bank. Now there are some other banks also, like the developmental bank, the export and import bank. So there are different type of bank. So commercial bank means in which the common people can open their bank account is called the commercial bank. For example, the ICICI Bank, the State Bank of India, the Punjab National Bank, all these banks are the commercial banks. I hope that the meaning of the commercial banks is clear to everyone. So this is another one. RBI facilitates all the banking activities for the central and the state government. So it has to be ensured by the RBI that whether the bank is following the banking activities according to the norms and regulations of the RBI itself or not. So these are the chief functions of the RBI. In the board examination, the functions of the RBI can appear. Explain four functions of the RBI. Then you have to write these four functions. I hope that the functions of the RBI are clear to everyone. So let's move to the next one. Now, what is the meaning of the bank? So the bank is a business organization. It is a commercial organization, commercial or business organization. The bank works as mediator between the depositors and the borrowers. Depositors mean those people who deposit their money, and the borrowers means those persons who issue money in the form of loan or credit. So they will be called the borrowers. Those who are taking the loan from the bank, they will be called the borrower, and those who are depositing money in the bank, they will be called as the depositors. So the people deposit their money in the bank and get some kind of interest as extra income. So if we try to define the bank is a business organization which works as a mediator between depositors and the borrowers. So it will be the definition of the bank. What is bank? So the bank is a business organization. The bank is a business organization which works as a mediator between depositors and the borrowers. I hope that you are making the notes and writing down all these points. So it works as a mediator between those who are in need of money and those who have the extra money. If anybody has the extra money, they can deposit the money in the bank, and on the saving, if anybody is depositing the money in the saving account, he will get the interest. So interest would be treated as a extra income of the people. So the bank holds only small percentage of their deposit in the bank, and the rest of the money is used by the bank to keep the loan. Because recently we have studied that the bank take money as well as it give money as loan. So whatever the money you are depositing, the individual is depositing, that money is also used for giving the loan to some other people. So I hope that the meaning of the bank is clear for everyone. So let's move. So the major portion of the deposited money is provided to those people who are needy of money for economic activities. So if anybody want to take loan from the bank, it can be given by the bank alone at the reasonable rate of interest. So if anybody is in need of money, it is given by the bank. So the same, it will give the same money which the other person has deposited in his account. So in case the money is provided as a loan with a higher rate of interest, it is not the higher rate of interest, it is on the same rate of interest which is decided by the RBI itself. But of course it is higher than the rate of interest deposited in the bank. Suppose if anybody is depositing the money in the bank, the rate of the interest is less. It will be around 4%. If you have deposited the money in the bank, whatever the interest rate you will get, is the 4% on the money you have deposited in your bank account. But whenever you are taking the money as a loan, the interest rate would be higher. It can be above 12%. So the difference between whatever the interest you are getting and the whatever the interest you are giving whenever you are taking the loan is the income of the bank. So I hope that this is clear for everyone. So what is the income of the bank is clear for everyone, I hope. So let's move. Now the loan activities of the bank. Only 15% of the cash, only 15% of the asset, asset means the total money of the bank is called the asset. Asset not only includes the cash but also any property. So any 15% of the cash asset as cash for pay to the depositor, the bank keep only 15% of the total asset. It means the total money. Now the asset can be in the form of gold or in the form of cash. So the 15% of the total asset of the bank should be kept as a cash to give cash to the depositors. And the difference between the interest on the borrowing money and the interest of the deposited money is the income of the bank, which we have discussed just now, that the difference between the interest on the depositing and the interest as the borrowing is the income of the bank. So I hope that this concept is clear for everyone. So let's move to our next topic.